हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर संगीता फ्रॉम डेंटल पाठशाला, वेयर वी हेल्प यू अंडरस्टैंड एंड लर्न डेंटिस्ट्री बेटर एंड इजी वे. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बी गोइंग ओवर द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर एक्टिवेटर. सो टुडेज टॉपिक विल कवर द कंस्ट्रक्शन बाइट, फैब्रिकेशन ऑफ एक्टिवेटर, द ट्रिमिंग ऑफ एक्टिवेटर एंड द मैनेजमेंट, द इंस्ट्रक्शंस व्हिच वी गिव टू द पेशेंट. नाउ प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड द हिस्ट्री ऑफ एक्टिवेटर व्हिच वाज गिवन बाय एंडरसन एंड हॉल, एंड ऑल्सो वी कवर्ड इंडिकेशन एंड कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेशन व्हिच इज यूज्ड इन ऑलमोस्ट all the cases rest except the vertical grower patient and the patient with a crowding, class 1 crowding patients. So we have already covered the advantages and the disadvantages and the mode of action, how the activator works. So if you haven't watched the video, I'll give you a link in the description below and up in the I button. Please watch the first part to understand the second part better. So let's get started. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel and click on the bell icon, that way you get a notification as soon as I release a video lecture. Now coming to the construction bite, first of all, as we all know about the activator, it is used to the forward positioning of the mandible. It is not only used to forward positioning of the mandible. Now you will know we can also posterior position the mandible, while in cases of class 3 malocclusion, when the mandible is protruded, we can also retrude the mandible. But majority of the cases, it is used for forward positioning of the mandible. The first thing we are doing is we are actually taking a bite. Now we all know how to take a bite with the help of a wax. So we'll study in the fabrication process. Now what we are doing is we are making a construction bite. So how we are making a construction bite? We are positioning the mandible of a patient. Now like how we did in centric jaw relation, while we talked about in the CD cases, we are positioning the mandible of the patient. Now the construction bite is actually an intermaxillary wax record. Now this is a wax record which relates the mandibular positioning when the patient is at rest position. Now bite responds to the mandible in forward positioning as well as in the vertical opening. As we all know, this is positioning the mandible forward, but also the vertical height is also increased. Now when the patient was closing mouth here, when the incisors were here, then the position was supposed to be till here. So what we have done is we have increased the lower facial height also. So we have two things, we'll talk about two things now. One is the vertical height and one is the forward positioning. Now the anterior advancement, that means we are taking the mandible anteriorly. So we will be studying two things. One is how much vertical we are raising and how much forward we are positioning the mandible, right? Are you still getting me? So there are two things. One is the vertical positioning. The vertical height is because we are placing a bite. We are placing a thick block inside it. See, this is the interocclusal bite. So this is the vertical height which we have increased. So we are studying two things. One is the vertical and another one is the anterior advancement. Now for constructing a bite, there are two things. Most of the cases we advance the mandible to 4 to 5 millimeters. So what we are doing is we are taking the mandible forward 4 to 5 millimeters. So the mandible anterior advancement, generally we can do up to 4 to 5 millimeters, which is our anterior advancement. But if we talk about the vertical opening, freeway space, as we all know, it is a physiologic space at the rest position. At the rest position, when you are at rest, your teeth are not occluding. Your maxillary teeth are not occluding the mandibular teeth. At space, there is, at rest, there is some physiologic space, which we call it the freeway space, because we have some free space in the mouth. So we at rest, we are not at maximum intercuspal position. When we are at resting, we are not clenching our teeth, right? We are at rest position, so there is some freeway space. So at the freeway space, we can extend the vertical height up to 2 to 3 millimeters. Now we can also go beyond, but we'll talk about general situation. We are talking about the general situation. Now in case when there is overjet is too large, when the overjet is too large, when there is class 2 division 1 case, right, and which is a severe class 2 division 1 case, now we want forward positioning of the mandible to a large extent, then what we can do is, because if we do it in a one step, then the patient is going to come up with a temporomandibular joint pain. ठीक है, बिकॉज वी आर एलिवेटिंग द मसल्स, वी आर स्ट्रेचिंग द मसल्स. सो वट वी आर गोना डू इज वी आर गोना डू दिस इन 2 to 3 फेजेस. सो वी आर गोइंग टू एडवांस 4 to 5 मिलीमीटर इन वन स्टेप. देन वंस द 4 to 5 मिलीमीटर एडवांसमेंट इज डन, देन देन अनदर स्टेप वी आर अगेन एडवांसिंग इट 4 to 5 मिलीमीटर. सो लाइक दैट वी आर डूइंग इट द ट्रीटमेंट इन 4 to 5 फेजेस. Now the other thing is, in the case of forward positioning of the mandible, when we are doing it 7 to 8 millimeters, the vertical opening should be slight to moderate. You have to see two things now. When there is vertical more, when the vertical advancement we are doing more, for example, if I tell you that vertical, if I am saying V is vertical, I am writing V as vertical. So vertical, if I am advancing 4 to 6 millimeter, which is a lot bigger than the forward positioning, than the advancement, the forward positioning of the mandible, the anterior advancement of the mandible is less. Now the anterior advancement in this case, where the vertical is more, then we are taking anterior advancement less. We can not take more than 3 to 5 millimeters. We cannot advance the mandible more than 3 to 5 millimeter. And when we are advancing the mandible anteriorly more, see, vice versa, if we take case, if we make the anterior advancement more, for example, in case of class 2 division 1 case, when anterior advancement we are doing 7 to 8 millimeters, then the vertical we are taking slight, then vertical we are taking less, then we are taking 2 to 4 millimeters. Are you getting my point? When vertical we are taking bigger, then anterior advancement we can do less. We have to do less. And when the anterior advancement we are doing more, then we have to take the vertical less. That means both the things we cannot take bigger. We cannot give the bite also big, and we cannot advance the mandible also big. Hame kya karna hai? Hum dono cheeze ek saath nahi kar sakte. Ya to hum vertically muh kholna, vertical height zyada bada sakte hain. Us case mein hame mandible ko aage kheench ke leke aana kam hoga. Aur agar hum log mandible ko zyada aage kheench ke leke aa rahe hain, jaise ki class 2 division 1 ke case mein hai, us case mein fir hame vertical height kam badhani hai. So if we are talking about the anterior advancement, if we are doing 7 to 8 millimeters, then the vertical we are going to take minimal, slight to moderate, which is 2 to 4 millimeter. And when the vertical we are doing more, for example, if we talk about the deep bite case, then we have to open the bite. When the patient is having deep bite, right, when we have to open the mouth, then in vertical, if we are raising, we are doing more than anterior advancement, we have to take less. See, this is the general consideration. So based on this, the construction bite is divided into 4 parts. The first one is a low construction bite with a marked mandibular forward positioning. See, I'll make you very easy. When the construction bite is low, that means the vertical height is less. Okay, when the vertical height is less and we are doing more of an marked advanced mandibular forward positioning, that means the vertical is less and the anterior advancement we are doing more. Then in that case the activator is called H shape. See, now this is a H shape. So H activator is when the vertical is less and the anterior advancement is more. When the anterior advancement is less than 3 to 5 millimeter and the vertical is minimal, so then that case we are giving H activator when the high construction bite and slight mandibular forward positioning. Now in low construction bite, we give it in case of class 2 division 1 malocclusion when the patient is a horizontal grower. Now you have to remember this, that horizontal grower we are giving H activator for horizontal grower, and high construction bite with slight mandibular positioning, that means vertical we are giving more. See, one is we are giving vertical less, the other one is we are giving vertical more. When we are giving vertical more and we are giving horizontal less, and then we are giving vertical mode. That means the construction, the activator is a V activator because we are giving vertical mode. Okay, it's very easy. You don't even have to memorize it. You will just remember it once you get the idea about it, the construction byte. Once you think about it, you will get. So when the vertical is high and the horizontal is low, then the activator is our V activator. Now in this case, the vertical height is 4 to 5 millimeter as we talked about, and the anterior is 3 to 5 millimeter. So anterior advancement is less and the vertical byte is more. So this is an vertical activator which we use in the class 2 division cases with the vertical grower. Now V for vertical, V for activator, and V means the vertical more. This is very easy. And if we talk about H, means the horizontal grower patient, class 2, both are class 2 division 1. The horizontal grower patient and the anterior advancement is more, vertical is less. Now coming to the construction bite without mandibular forward positioning, that means we are giving a construction bite, but we are not doing the mandibular forward. We are not forwarding the mandible, so there is no forward positioning, just there is increase in the bite. That's it, the vertical is there, there is no horizontal. There is no advancement of the anterior advancement of the mandible. So it's just the vertical increase. So we do it in case of deep bite or open bite class 1, which we talked about in the indication. If you have watched the previous video, that class 1 deep bite and class 1 open bite situations. The fourth situation is when the construction bite with opening and posterior positioning of the mandible. See, till now we have talked about we are forwarding the mandible. Abhi tak humne kya baat kiya, sirf hum mandible ko aage kheench rahe hain. Now what we are discussing is we are actually taking the mandible posteriorly. Which case will take mandible posteriorly? Of course, class 3 division cases, class 3 malocclusion cases, in which the mandible is already protruded, we are taking the mandible back. So the positioning, we are taking the mandible posteriorly in this case. The mandible we are taking posteriorly, and there is some vertical opening. The construction bite, the vertical in this case is 5 millimeter and posterior positioning is 2 millimeter. We cannot take the mandible too forward because the condyle, there is a stop for condyle which is already the posterior mat. If we talk about the centric relation, if you have watched the centric relation video, it is a posterior superior and posterior positioning of the condyle and the glenoid fossa. So we cannot take more posteriorly. So there the posterior positioning is only 2 millimeters, but vertical opening is 5 millimeter for this. So this is about construction bite. Now it's the time that we fabricate our activator, we prepare our activator. Now the upper impression and the lower impressions are taken, and two impressions are taken. One is used for study model and the other one is used for working model and the bite registration. Now we calculate the amount of vertical as well as the advancement, the anterior advancement we have to do. So the amount of sagittal and the vertical advancement of the mandible is planned, how much the mandible we are going to put forward and how much the vertical height we are going to keep. So based on that, we are going to make a bite. That's it. So the bite we are doing is we are actually softening the wax, and the wax should be 2 to 3 millimeter thicker than the planned vertical height which we are going to increase. So whatever the planned vertical height which we are going to increase, we are taking 2 to 3 millimeters thicker than that, and we are actually placing, we are asking the patient to sit upright. So when the patient is sitting upright position, we are guiding the mandible of the patient. So what we are doing is we are guiding the mandible with the help of our thumbs and forefingers, and we should not use pressure or the force, too much of pressure should not be applied, and the patient is asked to practice the placement of the mandible at the desired position where we want the mandible to advance. So how much ever forward positioning we want, first we'll guide that to that position and we'll ask the patient to practice in that position, and then we put the horseshoe shaped wax block. Now we put a U shape, we soften the wax block 2 to 3 millimeter thicker than the desired vertical height, and we place on the patient's lower teeth, all the occlusal surfaces and the incisal surfaces of the teeth, and we gently press so that the indentations of the lower buccal teeth have come. Now the wax block are placed on the lower jaw, and we ask the patient to bite at the desired position, at the desired sagittal position where we want. Because vertical height we have already there, and we want the sagittal or the advancement, the mandibular advancement we want. So wherever we have trained patient, we ask the patient to forwardly close the mandible to the desired location, and then the vex block is removed and placed on the model, and then we check it on the model, and after that we cross check the bite, and then we chill it, we put it in the cold water, and then we actually again place it in the patient mouth, and then we try it. So the waxed bite is placed on the occlusal surfaces between the upper and the lower models, and then we close the upper and lower models, and then we articulate it on the articulator. So next thing we do is, once we have articulated both the upper and lower models along with the bite, now we can remove the bite, we have articulated it, and we prepare the wax elements onto the models. Now the usual design is the upper labial bow. See, this is the upper labial bow. So on the upper teeth we are making a upper labial bow using 0.8 to 0.9 millimeter of wire, and the wire is consisting of two horizontal sections with two vertical loops. Now these ends of the vertical loop enter the acrylic body between the canine and the first premolar, or if deciduous molar is present, then the deciduous molar. Now the labial bow can be active or passive, it depends on the situation. We'll study about it during the trimming of the activator. Now we fabricate the acrylic portion onto the cast which we have. We secure the wires with the help of sticky wax, and then if we are using cold cure, we directly make it with a cold cure, and in case we are using heat cure resin, the models are first waxed and then flasked. Now we are making three portions. The first one is the maxillary part, the middle one is the intraocclusal part, and the lower one is the mandibular part. So this is how we fabricate an activator. Now after the fabrication of activator, it is usually tightly fit as acrylic between the teeth, upper and lower occlusal surfaces. Now the planning treatment begins in the appliance where it is contacting tooth surface area, and it is. Now these acrylic surfaces, these red colors are the acrylic surfaces, and they transmit the force in the by contacting the desired teeth, we are getting the desired forces, and these are known as the guiding planes, and the area of acrylic that contact the teeth actually should be polished. So till now we have covered the acrylic, the fabrication. Now it is well polished, well finished, where it is contacting the tooth surface, and it is approximately trimming can be done on the plaster casts itself, but the final trimming is done when the patient is done chair side, when the patient is on the chair. Now trimming of the activator, it involves in the three planes of space. Now coming to the vertical control, selective trimming can be done to intrude or extrude the teeth. Now if we are talking about intruding the teeth, it is as simple as that. Now intruding the incisors, actually this blue color is the labial bow which we have placed, and the red color is the acrylic part. Now it is achieved by loading the incisal surfaces of these teeth with the acrylic. Now we are placing acrylic up to the incisal surfaces if we want to intrude the teeth. And if we talk about the labial bow, it should be placed below the area of convexity, that is the incisal surface, to aid in the intrusion. Now if you are placing a labial bow at the incisal surfaces, this is very understood that it is putting the pressures and thereby intrusion, and the stop is here, so it is intruding the teeth. Now if we talk about molars in the posterior teeth, only the cusp tip are loaded with the acrylic part, and the fossa or the fissures are free of acrylic, so therefore the forces are coming up on the cusp, and thereby it is causing intrusion of the teeth. Now because this acrylic is forcing pressure on the cusp tip, so it is causing intrusion of the upper and the lower teeth. Talking about extrusion, in cases of extrusion, now in cases of incisor, the lingual surface is loaded above the area of greater convexity. In the maxilla, we are talking about the acrylic part. So acrylic part in the maxilla, it is the gingival 1/3, which is above the greater convexity in the maxilla, and below the area of greater convexity in the mandible, and the labial bow is placed above the area of greater convexity, which is at the gingival 1/3. So for intrusion, the labial bow is placed incisally. For extrusion, the labial bow is placed gingival 1/3. So this is the major difference between the intrusion and the extrusion. So if you place the labial bow at the incisal 1/3, then you will get the intrusion, and if you place the labial bow at the gingival 1/3, then there will be extrusion of the teeth. And in cases of molars, the extrusion is brought by loading the lingual surfaces above the greater convexity in the maxilla and below the greater convexity in the mandible. Again, this is same at the 1/3 gingival, 1/3 for maxilla and incisal, 1/3 for mandible. If we talk about in the directions in the sagittal plane, if we want the activator to work for the sagittal control, now selective trimming of the activator can be done also to intrude or to extrude, and other than that, we also use activator, we do selective grinding for proclination and retrusion of the teeth. Now we are actually using the incisors, we are actually using the activator to either protrude the incisor. For example, if the incisors are retruded, so we are using activator to protrude the incisor. And if in case of class 2 division 1, in case of the incisors which are protruded and we are retruding the incisors. So if we talk about the protrusion, the lingual surface of the teeth are loaded with the acrylic. So all of the lingual surfaces loaded with the acrylic. Now it is very obvious then that there is a passive labial bow which is given. Now when the acrylic is putting force, then the labial bow is far forwardly placed, so there is a space, so there is a pressure which is exerting, and thereby it protrudes the, so if the pressure is coming from acrylic part, then the teeth will come like this. So there is proclination of the incisors which is happening when there is a passive labial bow is placed away from the teeth to prevent the tissues contacting the teeth. Now there are two types into this. One is if the entire lingual surface is loaded with the acrylic, and in this case the contact is more, the force for proclination is also low. And the second case scenario is if only the incisal surface is loaded. And if the incisal portion of the lingual surface is loaded, acrylic contact is small and greater degree of force is generated up the incisal labially. Now coming to the retrusion. In this, the proclination, we have given the passive labial bow. If we talk about retrusion of the incisors, acrylic is trimmed away from the lingual surfaces. Now there is no acrylic in the lingual surfaces and we are giving a labial bow which is active. Now this labial bow is putting pressure, and since there is no acrylic out there, so this pressure, there will be retrusion of the teeth. So teeth will come like this, touching the later on in the later stages, touching the acrylic part. So there will be retrusion of the teeth when we are giving active labial bow and when there is acrylic trimming from the labial surfaces. Also, it is possible to trim the activator even to stimulate the arch expansion. We can also expand the arch of the buccal segment, and this is done by allowing contacting the acrylic part on the lingual surfaces of the tooth move transversely. But better the expansion is possible by placing jack screw, which in the Wondrous modification we place a jack screw, so like that. But Wondrous modification is used for class 3 malocclusions. Now this is about the trimming of activator. We are actually guiding the tooth movement. We are actually bringing the dentoalveolar changes as per desire, as per our wishes, like how we want the teeth to move. We are adjusting, we are trimming the acrylic into the desired tooth movement. We'll again revise it. Agar ab revise karenge to intrusion mein kya hai, hum log labial bow ko incisally rakhenge. Incisally rakhenge to kya hoga, intrude karenge. Aur agar labial bow ko gingivally rakhoge तो क्या होगा, दांत एक्सट्रूड करेंगे, बाहर आएंगे. और अगर आपको दांत बाहर की तरफ प्रोक्लाइन करने हैं तो उसके लिए हम क्या करेंगे, अंदर से एक्रिलिक को तो पूरा टच करेंगे ताकि अंदर से फोर्स आए. जब अंदर से फोर्स पड़ेगा और लेबियल बो थोड़ी सी दूरी पे रखा हुआ है, लेबियल बो पैसिव है, तो बाहर की तरफ क्या आएगा, फोर्स आएगा तो प्रोट्रूड कर जाएंगे दांत, तो हमारे प्रोक्लाइंड हो जाएंगे दांत. और अगर हम बात करते हैं लेबियल बो को हमने अंदर से थोड़ा सा घिस रखा है और लेबियल बो एकदम एक्टिव दिया है, यानी दांत को एकदम सटा हुआ लेबियल बो है, जब दांत को सटा हुआ और कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर डाल रहा है तो वो दांत को अंदर की तरफ पुश करेगा. और इवन अगर अंदर थोड़ा सा स्पेस प्रेजेंट है तो क्या होगा, दांत अंदर धस जाएंगे. सो दिस इज अबाउट द ट्रिमिंग ऑफ द लेबियल बो. इफ वी टॉक अबाउट मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द अप्लायंस, नाउ द पेशेंट शुड बी कन्विंस्ड to offer desired result, he should be convinced to constantly wear it, and we should actually motivate the patient. We should educate the patient by using videotapes, booklets, and the patient is also taught how to use, how to place, how to remove the activator all by himself, because while we are giving a removable appliance, we always do that. And since the patient is in a mixed dentition period, the patient is a child patient, so we actually need
to teach the patient, and usually the patient is asked to wear the appliance for 2 to 3 hours. Now 2 to 3 hours during the daytime for the first week, and during the second week the patient is asked to wear it for the 3 hours during the daytime, as well as sleeping in the night time. The whole night the patient should be wear, and in case the patient is using difficulty in wearing it whole time, then we should add the hours in the daytime. So we should prefer more in the daytime, and we should prescribe more in the daytime, so that until the patient is adjusted to wear in the night time, and a trimming plan should be developed based on the individual needs of the patient. And some orthodontic prefer the appliance to be worn for a week without any grinding, so that the patient get used to it. So this is about activator, which is used to activate, which is used to activate the elevator muscles, which brings about the mandibular forward movement. Also we can use it for bringing the backward movement of the mandible, but majorly it is used for forward positioning of the mandible when the patient closes the mouth. So this is about activator. I hope that I helped you understand the activator better, and if you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment below. Also please leave it in the comment below the next subject you want to start, you want to read with us. And if you feel that you have learned something new today, I have made you understand the activator easy, then go ahead and hit the comment box and the like button, because this helped me to help you skyrocket your career and knowledge while you stay at home in the lockdown with your family.